Today I want to share with you yet another experiment I did in order to better understand what it takes to build a small size self-sustaining aquarium with fish. This time I used a 3-liter plastic bottle. Fill up the bottle with dechlorinated water. Add some gravel. Here I use a seashell to anchor a epagnogeton. Another seashell to anchor hair grass. This eladea plant is long and has a couple new stems growing. I cut it in 4 pieces. Next I add some frog bits. Also it comes with some duckweed. Next I add 4-pound snails. They feed on algae and remains of organic matter like wilted plants. And most importantly, pond snails climb out of water to breathe atmospheric air. Also I add some sea shrimp. I leave the aquarium open for 5 days. December 21st, 2018. I give snails a pinch of homemade fish food flakes. Close the bottle tightly with a bottle cap. This is a closed ecosystem where plants and algae consume CO2 and dissolve nutrition, waste, while producing oxygen and get eaten by snails and sea shrimp who consume oxygen and produce waste and CO2 for plants and algae. Also there are bacteria and it's all more complicated than I described. Similarly set up aquariums with access to atmosphere can self-sustain for number of years. Let's see how it goes in this tank. January 2nd, 2019. All 4 snails crawling around. Here you can see planarian. I don't see pouches of snails' eggs so far. Normally pond snails lay eggs in the first days they get in new aquariums. They would not lay eggs only if conditions in aquarium are not suitable for breeding. So something is wrong here. Planarian can eat snail eggs, but planarian would not remove the egg pouches. So I keep looking, trying to identify the problem. Observation is the key. And the answer is right here. Pause and look at it. January 7th, 2019. The abnormality we spotted 5 days ago persists. Walls of the bottle get sucked in even more in the last couple days, making 2 large dents. It indicates lower air pressure inside of the aquarium than it is outside. January 28, 2019. Only 1 small dent in the wall remains. Some leaves of epagnogeton are wilted. February 25, 2019. Some eladea plants wilted in the past month. I don't see egg pouches of pond snails. The walls are without any dents. March 6, 2019. I see only 2 active snails. Yet I don't see any eggs. About half of eladea plants wilted. Seed shrimp seem to be fine. March 11, 2019. Duckweed and frogbit plants seem to do better than other plants so far. April 1, 2019. I see only 1 active snail. Plants are dying. The end of this project. April 5th, 2019. I modify this aquarium with holes in the upper part of the aquarium to allow air circulation while reducing water evaporation. I have been testing this design for a couple years now with good results in smaller aquariums. Check links in the description for details. Have fun and happy aquariums!